The Internal Revenue Service admitted today that some of its employees targeted conservative political groups.
Motherfuckers! In a few short weeks, you've managed to show that when the government wants to do good things, your managerial competence falls somewhere between David Brent and a cat chasing a laser pointer.
Well, if it took the mainstream media this long to finally pay attention to Benghazi, despite Fox shining a spotlight on the same thing for almost a year, what does it say when the administration loses credibility with Jon Stewart on this IRS snooping thing? Michelle Fields says more than you may know, and more trouble for the president, maybe as a result. Michelle, what do you make of this?
Well, first off, it's not surprising that Jon Stewart's going after Obama for the IRS. No one's going to defend the IRS. That's basically the worst agency for Obama to have a problem with, because Democrats aren't going to defend him. Everyone hates the IRS.
Well, you would have thought. I mean, seriously, I was naive enough to think when this first came out that, okay, they were targeting conservative groups. Liberals actually might quietly applaud. But then when I heard Harry Reid coming out this, and then of course, Jon Stewart, that obviously it had, just as you said, more weight to it than I appreciated.
The AP scandal is adding on to this. You know, reporters see this as their livelihood being threatened. The DOJ is compromising the relationship between a reporter and a source.
Yeah, but even that one, I know you're going to think I sound like a heretic here, but in that case, it's about... There was a well-being here, a protection, life or death issue. I'm not allowing
it.
I know, but I remember a lot of conservative reporters are the same ones who were gassed at the Pentagon papers being printed in the New York Times. That was then. I know this is now. I will say this, I think it's a bigger and more seminal development, this IRS thing, because it calls into question, you know, using a government agency, one of the most feared on the planet, to batter your enemies, and no one likes that.
And now we've learned that the IRS was actually leaking documents from conservatives, their applications for tax exemption, to liberal progressive groups. So that is incredibly dangerous. I mean, that is chilling. And then, I mean, I know you don't think that this is a very big situation with the AP, but
I'm not minimizing it. I'm more understanding of it than I certainly am the IRS thing. I'm not excusing it, trust me.
But if I'm a source, I'm not going to go to the AP knowing that they have a history of the government snooping on their cell phones, their home phones, their work phones.
Yeah, but in a terror world, you want to find out who is compromising that security within the government. I'm not, again, I know I sound like out of sync with a lot of people, but I do say that there are extenuating circumstances for that. Not on this, because the IRS using it as a bully to sort of embarrass you and to call you out, that's never good.
Exactly. And also, you're seeing the media turn, because on Friday, we also had the White House have a secret meeting where he picked a handful of reporters, a select group of reporters, to come talk about Benghazi. So people in the press corps are saying, wait a second, why wasn't I invited? So there's all these scandals adding up.
That's a very good point.
Benghazi, then you've got the IRS, and so they can't ignore it anymore. And
well,
it's
the
balloon's
off the rails, that's for sure. How long do you think that lasts?
I think it's going to continue to get worse. We're going to see more and more leaks with Benghazi, with the IRS, and with AP.
We shall see. All right. Thank you, Michelle.